My name is Gorilla Mezzo, the voice of Scuramezzo's High Intensity Tournament, and I am here tonight to welcome you to the grand finals of shit. Ladies and gentlemen, we are gonna get started right now. We got two semifinal matches to get through to find out who is going to the main event, and we also have a very special 30-man over-the-top Royal Rumble with every shit competitor except the final two. We're gonna start off right now. Both of the semifinal matches will be a 1v1 normal match. No tricks on this one. Just good, pure, old-fashioned wrestling. And let's go to the ring to welcome Lean Guerra.
Thanks for the intro, Gorilla. I'm James McMahon.
Oh, yeah, and also we let him in the booth again for some dumb fucking reason. But welcome aboard, Jim. Thanks
out
for
of
coming.
You if you didn't.
yeah. Getting a little aggressive. Oh, why, thank you, Tri. You got to dress for the occasion. And the occasion tonight is Lean Guerra, one half of the Two Heads champions, entering for his semifinal match against Muppet Pac-Man, who is going to go to our main event. I'm being told the main event will be held in Hell in a Cell 2 out of 3 falls to make sure the biggest shithead of them all is not an argument, no questions, no tricks, no nothing. Cage gonna keep him in, and we're gonna see it to the bitter sweet finale of shit.
Well, that does sound poo. But everybody, make sure you drop a screw or follow, by the way.
Yeah. Even though we're feuding and I hate you, Jimps.
Please,
give me your followers, people. Because the more people that follow me, the more I'll feel good about myself. And the more I feel good about myself, the more I'll spend time streaming this bullshit for you.
Aw, oh, yeah.
All right, Lean Guerra has made his way into the ring, and next up, the former unnatural snacker, no longer with his big buddies, here comes Muppet Pac-Man. His snakes are going to lead him out there, top of the ramp. Let's wiggle our way into the ring, Muppet Pac-Man.
Okay, now Muppet Pac-Man's a pretty good wrestler, of course. He is the ping-pong cruiserweight champion of the JFW. But it's just a shame he's a shithead, isn't it, really?
Well, you know what? That would, you're going to have to take that up with your boss, Mr. Jimps McMahon, putting him into a situation in which he would get fired from JFW, shit scooped him right up, and then he came back and stole that Plim Plom Cruiserweight Championship away from the JFW. But here we go, one-on-one action, your semifinals. It's Muppet Pac-Man, it's Lean Guerra, and this is shit.
It certainly is, Gorilla.
That joke gets a little old, Jimps.
Just like you.
You're older than me. By like a...
I don't look it, though.
Oh, well. All right, ref having to break them up early. Oh, a little cheap shot there from Muppet, a little bit of gamesmanship. These two know each other pretty well from the tech division. Lean Guerra just showing off his agility there. Leapfrogging into harm's way, apparently. Muppet with the arm drag takedown and right back on top of Lean Guerra. No counter. Countered, nice maneuver by Lean Guerra as he goes right back in. Ooh, drops the elbow into the head, and then the inverted atomic drop. That'll slow anyone down. Oh, a second one just to make sure. And look at this, works him into the corner here. Can we see that? No, I thought he was going to smash his head into that turnbuckle. Loves doing that. Instead, going for a bigger move here. Tree of Woe and knees him to the midsection. Lean Guerra firmly in control right now. And going for a quick pin to end it. Not even a one count, or just past the one count.
Yeah, it was a very, very optimistic pin attempt there by Lean Guerra.
Well,
I wonder if the Country Wizard will be making an appearance in this match.
Well, I gotta believe the Country Wizard has pulled all of the magic out of both of his voluminous sleeves, because I can't imagine they would let him come in and spoil yet another match in this tournament. Let's see if we can get a pure match out of these two and see what happens.
Yep.
But you never know with the dastardly duos, the tag team champions. They will pull out all the stops for a win, folks.
They will.
But Lean Guerra thus far, very measured, really trying to control Muppet Pac-Man. Muppet trying to get his speed up, and there you go, dumps him to the outside. Muppet very pleased with that maneuver.
Not for long, though.
No, not for long. We've seen plenty of matches get spoiled by a little bit of over-celebration. Some of our best competitors are the guys that can keep their heads. Look at this, Lean Guerra thinking top rope here. Not a high flyer by trade, but he has been going up there more and more recently. And he just drops that big elbow right to the back of the head, and Muppet Pac-Man rolls out of the ring to try and gather himself. Lean Guerra okay with it, taking a little breather himself. And now pursuing Muppet, and he did not fall for the trap. Quick counter, and he stays in. No, he doesn't. Wow, these two, they know each other so well.
Yeah, of course. Muppet Pac-Man used to be a snacker, didn't he? In contention always. The perennial title contenders, just because apparently Gorilla Metzor liked sucking them off. And
well, you know, I gotta say, I always rooted for the Unnatural Snackers, but I think their time has come and passed. You know, you heard it from Scaramezzo. He even called out JFW saying there was no heart, there was no soul anymore. And I think the Snackers are dead and dusted. Look at this, though, a pinfall here. No, just a two count after the Scorpion Death Drop. And again, Lean Guerra not looking for the cheers, not looking for the applause, just looking to wear out his opponent. Is the quality
it looks
not looking?
It looks different
from normal,
doesn't it?
Is it coming? The quality might. Yeah, that's weird. Does it look really bad?
It looks a bit weird.
Interesting.
It just looks different, doesn't it? Because your settings are a bit different than mine, I think.
Yeah, well, there's that, but also.
Stream might be lower quality with you not being partnered.
I don't know. It should. I don't know. Who knows? Who knows what it's streaming at? Apologies for that. But, yeah, I know I exported it at 1440 by accident. That's part of the reason it was so big. So it shouldn't matter. But
no, it's fine. You might just have to change the settings on your stream, actually, because I've just changed them on mine. It was a bit crap on mine, but I've changed the settings. So
it might not default to 1080. It should be streaming in 1080, though, I think.
Yeah. It should
be 1080 60p, but I don't know. Oh, actually, you know what? Yeah, maybe I exported this in 50p by accident. Or 48, whatever. Doesn't matter. This is what you're getting, because we're certainly not going to stop the fight now. Oh, and look at this. Muppet might be hurt. Ref calling a check on him here. Lean Guerra having to pull back. No, he just shoves the ref out of the way and continues on. Not to steal a phrase from Calcium Kaz, but there is no mercy in this dojo. The cowboy with the pinfall here might have it. Yeah, it's possible. It's possible to Scotty.
Might have to lock in the six shooter, mightn't he? Or the, or the whatever the death drop is called.
Oh, look at this, though. Here comes the 619. Muppet sticks the landing. Haven't seen one of those in a while. And he plants him. This could be it, Jim.
It could be, yeah.
He's got the pinfall here. He's put away a lot of people with this move. No, just the two count. Lean Guerra kicking out.
I mean, normally he needs about seven of those, but yeah.
True.
But it has won matches before.
Sure has.
Oh, a big slap from Lean Guerra. What is this move? I've never seen this before, Gorilla.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Lean Guerra went to that last week, too, I believe, setting him up and dropping the knees right through him. That'll knock the wind out of you, and he's counting on it right here with this pin. Oh, a lingering two count there. But the match is going to continue one more time.
Beating his chest.
And here he goes, firing himself up here. Look at this. Running right through him with three consecutive clotheslines. Going for that slow motion stinger splash. Nope, didn't work out for him once again. Oh, and look at this, though. Into the Boston Crab. We've never seen this end matches before, Jim.
Doesn't look like we're going to either, does it?
No, my goodness. He tapped. Lean Guerra caught him in that Boston Crab. And he tapped, deciding to go to Scaramezzo's hometown with the Boston Crab for the finishing move. Gets the victory. Lean Guerra, with the least exciting music in wrestling, is going to the finals of Scaramezzo's high-intensity tournament. Muppet Pac-Man taps, but that will not be the last. We will see a Muppet Pac-Man tonight. He will be competing in the third place match, and he will be one of 29 other men to enter the 30-man Royal Rumble. All of the shitheads, except for the final two, will be in that match right before the main event.
Yeah, I thought it was actually, like, I thought that was the animation for reversing it. That was.
Yeah. I thought for sure he was coming out of that, and then he just gave up and tapped. No, the finale, the final match is 2 out of 3 falls. Both of the semifinals are just 1v1 normal. First pinfall. Now, here is a match we've been talking about, speculating about for weeks. Dressed for Business, Lemon Is Good versus Fant Fox, having a meet in the semifinals. Will this fracture their friendship? Will this fracture them as a team in general? But here they come, one-on-one. What's up?
I said, let's hope so.
We'll see. I don't think we've ever seen them compete one-on-one before. So this should be something.
Yeah, hopefully we see plenty of concussions and
wow.
Let's hope these two shitheads really
I took a lambasting on Monday night for talking down about some mid-carders, and you're actively rooting for these guys who put their lives on the line for our enjoyment to get hurt. What's that say about you? What's that say about the attitude of the JFW?
Says I'm not a shithead.
Disgraceful.
Says I'm not a shithead.
Absolutely disgraceful. You know, we welcomed you into the booth here as a shot, just a little bit of a sign of unity. But really, we just wanted you here to make me look good. We always know that's the case. So welcome aboard, Jim. I appreciate the candor, but oh boy, watch your words.
Why don't you watch your words unless you want them?
No, no.
Out.
Why don't you watch your words, sir?
Why don't you watch your words? Unless you want them punched down your throat.
Oh, wow. I don't know if some 8-toed geriatric old man who won't even put a face cam on anymore, because we all know he's gone a little bit extra soft there, really wants to start a war of words with this right here. I might be, just a commentator, but I'm still built like a brick fucking shit house, and I'll run you out of any ring you ever want to step in, Jimps.
I'd like to see you try. It'd be like fighting a little 5-year-old where you put your hand on the head.
Oh, yeah. You try that, see what happens. Your wrist will get broken, and then your back will, too. So you'll be laid up with Mr. Jimps McMahon and Jimmy Min-Max-Tastic and any other fucking dickbag that you want to throw out there other than yourself. So we could have a talk about that later. I don't want to take away from this amazing semifinal match.
Yeah. Two absolute shitheads on display.
Absolutely. Fan Fox and Lemon Is Good, dressed for business, always vying for those two heads championships. And look at this, going right after each other.
Yes, MC. Oh, cheers, Frosty. Glorious. I'd take Mighty EF over these shitheads any day of the week.
Well, yeah, I wouldn't doubt that you would. No, no one that's ever watched a half second of JFW programming doesn't think that any JFW loyalist wants nothing but Mighty AF, because that's all you get on that show. Thank you, Discotti. I like to hear it. Oh, boy. Fan Fox thinking about going top rope. Changed his mind very clearly.
No, don't worry, Lemon. They wouldn't let that happen here at shit.
Oh, and went for that flying forearm. The corkscrew with the forearm there misses, and Lemon taking over here. No counter by Fan Fox. These two know each other. I mean, they've trained together for years now to get to this position, and now they have to go one-on-one. And both of them love this nice monkey flip move there. Lemon the first one to hit it, and now Fan Fox having to roll outside of the ropes to recover.
He needs to hit him with that crab walk, doesn't he, to get back into the mat? Huge right hand. It looks like they want to go for a count out win, doesn't it?
Yeah. I don't know what the tournament contingency plans for a double count out would be. So let's hope we don't get to that point.
Just stick a pin in him.
Yeah, Fan Fox not letting this one go to a count out. He's coming right back after him to bring him back in. Lemon, however, might have different thoughts here.
No.
And yep, Fan Fox says, no, absolutely not. We're not playing this game. Goes right back in the ring. And now the action continues where it belongs. Oh, and Fan Fox paid for that. But, oh, and look at this. Lemon going top rope here. He's lining him up. Oh, and beautiful, beautiful maneuver into a pinning predicament here.
A Hurricane Rana, an actual Hurricane Rana.
Yeah, into the pin, and no, just the two count kick out. Oh no, and then the big stomp. Now, whoever does lose this match will have to immediately come back out for another match. Don't know the stipulation on that one, but it is a special third place match, and that is a gauntlet, because after that, they've got a 30-man rumble. I am being told that the number three and the number four, the two people, one of which we know will be Muppet Pac-Man, will be the last two people to enter in that tournament to give them something of a break. Excuse me, rumble, not tournament. Four count, and Fan Fox again breaking that count, going right back in the ring. Oh, and Lemon is all over Fan Fox right now. European uppercut, beautiful European uppercut. And now just stomping a mud hole in his chest there, in the corner. Fan Fox in some serious trouble now. Look at this,
really,
though. Lemon lining up. Jimps, you got to know how this goes. You got to line up your attack, and that's why. Oh, he didn't spend long enough, and he missed. But then he came in and still got that neck breaker in. Needed to spend a little bit more time just standing there doing nothing, I think. Oh, but here comes the Lemon drop. Is he going to hit it? He is. Nails the Lemon drop. This is over.
It could be.
Ooh, a late two-count kick out. Fan Fox staying in it. You know, we've seen a lot of perseverance from Fan Fox in this tournament. Lemon having to go top rope. You can tell he's agitated. Oh, and he misses the leg drop. Oh, no. And then Fan Fox missing the whatever the fuck that was.
Oh, dear.
Oh, but look at this. No, he was looking for that sharpshooter, that poorly implied sharpshooter. Oh, and he just countered the left. Oh my God! Counters the Trouble in Paradise into that DDT. And now again going back to those legs. Hey, Flicky. Yeah, sorry, we were a little bit behind in our scheduling and everything. Ooh, and a two count by Lemon. Who is going to advance to the finals?
And more importantly, who cares?
Well, I'm gonna wager it's all 38 viewers in the stream and the millions at home watching some other way, I'm sure. I think all those people care. Oh no, look at this. He's lining up another one. This is how he beats Scuramezzo.
Oh, wow.
Going coast to coast, Lemon. Is he gonna fly again? Oh, he does, he hits him, it is over. Lemon's going to the finals. Lemon is going to the finals.
If he ever pins him.
If he ever, he's got to get him right in the middle of the ring. And there it is, 1, 2, 3. If that beats Skuro, that's beating Finn. No, barely a two count. Unbelievable stuff. FanFox just staying in this somehow. But he's gonna have to turn it on if he's gonna come back. Lemon's got all the energy and all the momentum right now. But there's that quick elbow. Oh, and there's that spine buster.
Oh boy.
Fan Fox, now he's creeping up on him, ran through him somehow. And now the pinfall, wouldn't this be something? Now just the two count kick out.
And yes, exactly, Johnny.
Oh, here we go, though. Here we go.
Oh, is this the Fox Bottom?
Oh, no, counters the Fox Bottom. And he does that beautiful double stomp. This time is running out for FanFox. He's going to have to come up with something big here. And I think that something big is a Trouble in Paradise to the face. This is over if he hits this. No, he ducks it. Gets out of the way, flying forearm by FanFox. This might be his last chance.
Oh, here's the comeback.
Aw, thank you, Lowler. And here we go. FanFox knows he needs something big here. Oh, he's going for that sharpshooter. He tried working the legs over before. Does he have him? He's got it locked in the middle of the ring. He did! He tapped out! He tapped out again! FanFox with that terrible sharpshooter. Nenega win. Back-to-back submission tapouts for both men to advance to the finals. Unbelievable stuff. FanFox versus Lean Guerra. 2 out of 3. Hell in a Cell is your main event. And commiserations, Lemon is good. What a tournament he has had, and it isn't over yet. He's coming right back out for the third place match, and we're gonna find out that stipulation in just a few minutes. And then following that match, 30-man Royal Rumble. Every competitor and shit except for the final two will be in that match. Should be something. Congratulations, FanFox. Congratulations, Lean Guerra. We'll see you in the finals.
Yeah, the worst sharpshooter in the history.
And there it is. Finish it match. We love these matches. These are 2 out of 3 to hit your finisher. Will it be Lemon is Good? Will it be Muppet Pac-Man? Let's get right back to ringside. It looks like Lemon's going to force us to watch his entrance again. He ran up the ramp and ran right back out, folks. Classic Lemon there.
Some people say he's a bit of a narcissist.
Just a bit. Some people say those are inflated muscles, too.
Oh, that's outrageous.
From the pits of hell. Well, unseen Walker, you know, I have heard rumors that you might be boycotting the Royal Rumble because you went back as a JFW loyalist. And that would be a real shame if you didn't show up as one of the 30 men, unseen.
It would be a shame because Unseen Walker is a JFW loyalist and he is not a shithead. And shitheads can just fuck off.
Oh, thanks, Lol. Yeah, these, if you don't know the story of the JFW and our counterculture here, shit, this is all run out of Jimmy Fantastic's stream. The JFW is all from the Blood Bowl universe of viewers. And, yeah, we got a whole thing going on there. Monday, Wednesday, Friday, 8 p.m. UTC. Check us out. Jimmy Fantastic is the Twitch handle to keep an eye on.
Thanks, Gorilla. At least you know who the billionaire boss, Mr. Jim McMahon, backs.
Look, I'm not going to, you know what? We might be running the rogue stream here on Scaramezzo's private Twitch channel. You know we don't know what we're doing streaming-wise, Jim, so we'll give it to you there. But we know, but by the grace of Mr. Jim McMahon's money, are we able to put these on. And frankly, if he pulls the plug on us, there's not much we can do at this stage. But he knows, I know somewhere deep down in his cold black heart, he knows exactly how good this is. And let's take a look at our first finisher here, the Trouble in Paradise. That's Lemons. If he hits two of those, the match is his and third place is his. And we'll take a closer look at Muppet Pac-Man's in just a few seconds.
Marcel transcends all
you. Yeah, Marcel has not made it over to Wednesdays on shit. And here we go, the snake, his finisher, not the 619. Two snakes, if he can hit him, he will be your third place winner in Scaramezzo's high-intensity tournament.
Yeah, the Trouble in Paradise is rather inaccurate. So we'll see what happens.
Yeah, well, I couldn't... Lemon, you're from Turkey, right? Is that correct? Is that where you live?
I believe so.
Yeah, I was going to change it to like the Trouble in Ankara or some ridiculously Turkish sounding town. But then I just like, I couldn't remember if that was right or not. And I didn't want to get it wrong. So I didn't do that. the next match is a Rumble, Lee and Guerra. This is the third place match. And then we're going into the 30-man Royal Rumble. And Lemon, again, can't keep his eyes on the prize. No, I didn't say that. Oh, look at this. Muppet, knowing it's because it's... a finish it match, anything goes weapon-wise. Grabbing one of those structural kendo sticks. There's a lot of extra structural kendo sticks under the ring now. As you've seen, the damage that Extra Arms Bot and Demon Prince Rick Reckless have inflicted upon shit rings of late.
Well, that is the problem, of course, when you have substandard rings. And, you know, everything about shit is substandard, really, isn't it?
Yes,
so it's no surprise that ring broke.
You know what? Again, we run in a smaller venue. We cater to our fans. We don't need the biggest audiences. We don't need to sell the most t-shirts. Everyone out there in the JFW universe knows exactly which night to sit and watch the best AI-based WWE 2K19 wrestling. And that's Wednesdays, 8 p.m. UTC on shit. Well, this is our final broadcast. Who knows what's coming next? Well, I think we're going to have to find out a little bit more this Sunday when shit takes over the JFW at Survivor Series, 8 p.m. UTC. Shit is going to end the life of the JFW.
Or they're going to run away with their tail between their legs like the absolute shitheads that they are.
All right, Lemon going back to it here, working that arm over. And you know these two want to make a quick work of this match, if at all possible, because they have already each gone through some pretty brutal matches earlier tonight. And Lemon, ah, we saw him fail at this before. Now he's really sizing up Muppet Pac-Man. He's looking him over. He knows he's got to hit him just right. Is he lining up that trouble in paradise? He's got to get that. I think he is. He's really thinking about it. Here we go. Lemon is good. He's taking all the time. Oh, he misses with the stomp. He missed with the stomp. He needed more time. And the action spills outside the ring.
This will count outside the ring, won't it, if he hits it here?
Absolutely, it does. And that's how we saw, I believe, our first finish it match, Night Demon winning with a zombie outside the ring. Oh, look at this. Lemon is good, going top rope. Dropping that elbow, flattening the littler man. But that's not how you end this match. No pinfalls to happen here. Oh, that's why this is happening. Because the AI wants to pin him right now. That's exactly what's happening, isn't it? Yeah. No, and looks like he's going to line him up one more time. He missed on that stomp before. Can he get him this time? Going to be rough. Okay.
Roll monkey flip. Oh, wow. Not even Northall from Muppet. Oh, God, he killed himself.
Yeah, Muppet missing with that wheel kick. And Lemon has really been dominant. I think we're moments away from our first score here. He's going to hang him up on those ropes, bouncing him off and back into the ring. And then working that arm over again. Really got to loosen up that arm so that he can kick him in the face with Trouble in Paradise that has nothing to do with his arms.
Absolutely, yes.
And now the legs. Going to those legs next. And here we go. Standing him up. Is this it? No, Muppet. Muppet on the counter here. Oh, what's Muppet thinking? Running. Oh, look at that. The interesting, the double leg. Oh, and right into the worm.
Whoa, the snake.
Excuse me, the snake nails it, and it's 1-0 Muppet striking, lightning quick strike out of nowhere with that one.
Most athletic Lemon in the world. That is the claim that he gets to stick. Absolutely.
Well, now he can be as athletic as he wants. He's got a long uphill uphill climb here to get two Trouble in Paradise is off to win this match as Muppet waits him standing on the top rope here. Oh no, but yo, look at this, the roll through, everyone fine on that miss. Nice takedown, and Lemon's got to celebrate. He might be down 1-0, but you know he's going to talk about it. And now he's going top rope one more time. Muppet right in the middle of the ring practically. And this is another leg drop. And Muppet out of the ring looking, nope, not looking for a weapon, just getting a little breather. Yes, Bezel, the double in paradise. If he can somehow hit the two kicks without touching the ground, it'll count. Oh, Muppet dropping him on that 30 feet of concrete flooring. Whew. Oh, no, but now Muppet taking his own spill there. Oh, and, you know, again, Lemon, not known for his power moves, looks like a power wrestler against a small man like Muppet.
Yeah, Muppet's tiny, isn't he?
He sure is.
Pretty soft, to be honest.
That's what I used to think about that a lot too, Leandera, watching his matches. Nice head scissors takedown. And Lemon could go for that worm, or excuse me, that snake again. No, he doesn't. Oh, we see that all the time. Muppet just shrugging off the double stomp right back on top and right up to the top rope. He's fired up now.
Outrageous. Little Muppet, what's he gonna do?
He was looking for a jumping DDT, but swatted aside by Lemon is good. Lemon drop coming, not a finisher though. But a very useful maneuver. This could be it though. Can Lemon score a tying finisher? No. Fireman's carry again. Lemon just a little bit too slow for Muppet and everything to try and polish this off. European uppercut, and now sends him into the corner. Oh, look at that, gets his legs up, the big punches, right back down, and into a European.
Pretty impressive stuff for shit.
Yeah, great match. I mean, again, third and fourth place contenders here. Oh, and here it could be, calling for that. Trouble in Paradise, does he have it? He does, he hits it, it's 1-1. Next finisher is going to win this match, folks.
Good.
Oh, Jim, I know you're having a good time out there. I know you are. Oh, look at this. Lemon gonna fly top rope looking outside. Oh, maybe he's reconsidering it. It's a pretty long way to go. Nope, he's waiting for him to get up. Oh, he flattens him with the crossbody. Ugh. 1-1 here, looking for a weapon now.
Yep.
Oh, and just nails him in the gut with that chair. Nope, he's not done with the chair. Oh, Muppet dodging out of the way. Oh, no! The unprotected chair shot to the head. That one caught him. And now, Lemon has all the advantage in the world. Can he get another Trouble in Paradise off is the question. We saw how quickly Muppet was able to turn around Lemon's last onslaught. Can he do it again and get the win here? Or is Muppet gonna walk out of here your fourth place contender? Once again, Lemon is good. Cannot help himself but to celebrate.
He does like that. Hmm.
Sure does. Oh, and again, rolling out of the ring one more time. Lemon going top rope one more time.
Doesn't look like it's going to save him.
Oh, he got him. Caught him somehow with that knee. It looked like in the shoulder, the back of the head. But once again, Muppet right back up to his feet. Yeah, probably Muppet. I don't think there is, but maybe one of the social stats or something. And here we go, stomping on that ankle. Muppet Pac-Man has taken a lot of damage recently, but really working over Lemon. It's disrespect, okay. Oh, this could, no, I thought he was setting up to do another snake there. And he just dumps him outside and he's gonna, is he going after him? Muppet is feeling it. He knows he's got to end this real soon.
Tossing him off.
Oh, no, but a counter. Quick counter by Lemon is good. European uppercut drops him. He's calling for it. He's calling for the Trouble in Paradise. This could be it. Oh, no, he got him. Lemon is good. Third place. Congratulations. You are our third place competitor in Scaramezzo's High Intensity Tournament. That means Dress for Business guaranteed to take 2/3 of the top 3 slots. That is a hell of a showing for a team that has never quite grasped the Two Heads Championships. But if you ask me, there's no one more deserving right now than Dress for Business, the shit aficionados, the shitheads themselves, Lemon is good, Fant Fox. Well done to Lemon. Can't wait to see Fant Fox versus Lean Guerra in the finals.
Well, and luckily, Gorilla, no one's asking you.
Well, I'm not sure that's true. And now it's time to shitstravaganza rumble. 30-man Royal Rumble. This is going to look like absolute garbage, folks. But hey, I got it on the first try.
Glorious.
And it looks Demon Prince Rick Reckless starting number one. So I guess we're starting this match in about 15 minutes.
Now, Rick's a great competitor. He should win this even from first, I think.
Sure is. And folks, I will be right back. I'm going to refill my water while Rick makes his entrance. Jim, keep us entertained.
I'll keep you entertained by letting you watch this great entrance that will take about 15 minutes. So brilliant. Exclamation point, end the turn. That won't work here. But yeah, if you need a toilet break or a break to read War and Peace or have a Rebel playoff game or whatever you're looking to do, there's plenty of time in this entrance. But it's a great entrance. It's a great entrance. It is a great entrance. It works fantastically well for the Demon Prince. It's absolutely glorious. What an absolute badass.
Well, looks like you might have done something because it doesn't seem to have lost half of our viewers as I was expecting. Thank you for that. And I see Rick made it halfway down the ramp.
That's a bit generous. He's just off the stage.
Oh, dear.
Repaint your house. Oh, dear. Well, you'll be able to watch it on jimmyfantastic.com or go to YouTube and search for Jimmy Fantastic and watch it there. All the JFW stuff. Very good. Very good.
At least he's got good music.
Yeah, I like the music. I like the entrance. I think it's great.
So, who is going to have the unfortunate pleasure of starting number two against Demon Prince Rick Reckless?
I've got a feeling it's going to be extra arms, but
I've got a feeling it's going to be Geeks War Game. it could be extra arms, but this is a random draw kind of thing, so who knows?
Yeah, okay. Should just find all of the longest parts and put them all together.
Yeah, no kidding.
See how long it would be. This has got to be one of the longest ones.
I'll be surprised if Unseen Walker enters this tournament. He said a lot of nasty things about shit. Has clearly put his hat in with. Oh, and there you go. Well called, Mr. Well, just Jim's. It's Extra Arms Bot number two, one and two. Demon Prince Rick Reckless, Extra Arms Bot. And yes, I did put those two, one and two, so that if I couldn't get this to run, I could just break the ring. That was my contingency plan if I couldn't get a 30 man. Just have them break the ring.
And yes, Foxamania, it's a packed show for shit. Yes, I'm sure they'll call this sold out arena.
This is actually a WWE arena. Unfortunately, the venue we have to use for all Royal Rumbles, just for licensing reasons, has to go through the WWE, and you can't put any crowds in a WWE arena these days. So, there you go. But you know what? I bet it's more populated than any of the 30-man Royal Rumbles that the JFW is running for you guys.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
And we're off and right into it. Extra Arms Bot taking out Demon Prince Rick Reckless. Oh, and that huge chop right off the bat. Yeah, it's... Humorous Chimp, I gotta turn the graphics so far down to get through 30. It's this or nothing. Sorry, guys. And number three, it's Geeks Wargaming. Oh,
I'm not
dear.
Sure denied in the tournament.
Accidentally intercepted in the extra arms, butt fudge.
That was epic.
But he's taking the fight to them. Good on him not going globetrotting again. Probably because I didn't have any time to to do anything more. Oh my goodness. Oh boy, and now the big undead himself, Gengar.
Oh boy. 7-footer.
And Gengar, yeah, almost as big as EAB, going right after him.
Yeah.
Geek's not having as good a time with Demon Prince Rick Reckless over there.
No.
Oh, Gengar might have Geek or EAB out. Oh, and look at that. There's Spike. You know, Spike and Gengar have been had a bit of history themselves recently. But not enough of one that they would go right after each other, apparently.
Taking on Rick is dangerous. Dangerous strategy. There is an awful lot of inhumanity. Yeah, we've got one man in the ring.
Yep.
I'm competitive.
And then whatever the fuck Ghoul Face kill.
He's a normal bloke, isn't he?
Yeah, he is. Oh, he's real small.
Is he going to eliminate EAB? Probably not. But you never
know. Oh, no! Oh, Geeks eliminated by Rick. So long, Geeks. Well played. Good tournament.
EAB and Rick again. Going at it. Oh, is EAB?
Oh, yeah. EAB! No, Rick hangs on! How did Rick hang on?
Unbelievable. And in comes Flicky Flack. Well, I've heard there's
Flicky Flack. Flicky Flack trying to hype up the no crowd there.
Yeah. You could hear him shouting at the crowd, I've got a spreadsheet.
Gengar rolling under the ropes to recover here. EAB taking it from Ghoulface. No, taking Ghoulface down. And look at this, Flicky might have Spike. He's got him on the ropes. No, Flicky just lost interest in Spike on the ropes there. Antsy. Antsy misses with a neck breaker and gets zombied and probably eliminated right now.
Oh my god, and during that, JFK was eliminated.
Oh boy. Oh, look at this! Oh, the flip me! And Thaw, the fastest he'll ever enter the ring, folks.
For sure. Oh yeah, of course, power.
Flicky just took Gengar out!
Unbelievable.
Imagine watching a wrestling promotion that refused to do Royal Rumbles, folks. Not a world I want to live in. Well, but well, Antsy might redeem himself here if he can get Flicky over those top ropes. He's got him over, but no Flicky hanging on.
He hurt his legs trying to kick him out.
Yeah. He decides to go for a smaller man now, but that smaller man is Night God. Demon. Oh my goodness.
That's ridiculous.
Now, Antsy's now just punching air in the middle of the ring to try and look busy. Oh, but look at this, the spear coming. Maybe. Oh, it is, Flicky. No, he countered him. Oh, wow, Thaw eliminating Demon Prince Rick. EAB not getting that honor as he sits on Oh, boy. And here comes McNaughton going in right after nobody.
Oh, dear. 35 going after EAB now.
Yeah, EAB was number two. EAB is out. No, EAB hung on. Holy crap.
Yeah, great updated tattoo.
And in comes Jaws's shithead aficionado. Oh my god, Flicky Flack from about 8 feet high, falling to the mat there. Oh, and now throttling and slamming him on top of Spike.
See you, Jaws's.
Thanks for playing, Jaws's. Not his night. EAB just like out of nowhere decided to eliminate him on that one. Oh, and this could be it for yep. Good night, Ansi. Well played. Oh, but look at this. Thaw has been on a tear. Just slammed EAB down. I think he's leaking some oil there.
Yeah. Whoa, Spike's going for
it. Oh, good night, Spike. Didn't even see who eliminated him.
It was McNaughton.
Oh, a crotch chop following. And now Thaw setting up EAB. This is it for EAB. He's been in since number two. Oh! What a counter by EAB! Thaw can't believe it. EAB is not going anywhere. He's on a mission, folks. He's eliminated like half of the competitors, too. Oh, the Friday fuckboy now. The Dread Mask, the Plim Plum Bloserweight.
Oh, wee wee wee. Yeah, he is. Attacks.
Oh, no way. Is the Bread Mask going to take him down? No. What? What the fuck?
Oh, McNaughton.
Yeah. No, not McNaughton. He's still in.
No, McNaughton eliminated Flicky Flack.
Yeah. And now, oh, at least these two are about size appropriate here. I'm too new for you trying to take down the Bread Mask, slow him down. Everyone else exhausted.
Oh, so
yeah, it didn't break him open. That move, I think, bloodies more people's heads than any other move in wrestling.
Maybe. What a curveball. It's a shame he's a shithead, but good to see him.
Yeah, Kurgle.
Good balls.
Kurgle going right after McNaughton. Unsuccessfully. I don't know what the Bread Mask is doing.
At least he's not getting hit by the
yeah, accurate. Oh, well, he's going out of the ring is what he's doing. Oh, there, here comes Blue Bomber. Might have not gotten all of his costume upgrades. Yep, this is classic Blue Bomber.
Looking very much like Skeletor.
Well, something tells me he's not going to last very long. Because EAB going right after him.
I think he nearly eliminated him right there, didn't he?
Oh! EAB hung on again. I thought after that he was gonna eliminate EAB, and I was just gonna start crying.
And here's Wolfbark. Watch out if you've got any eggs. Don't throw them at him. Here he is.
Well, yep. Good night, Blue Bomber. Thanks for coming.
I'm too new for you. I'm gonna go at EAB here sometime. Just too fast for him, isn't he? My goodness.
As soon as Wolfbark came out, my dog started getting a little crazy. He might be about to kill someone.
He's got to see. Well, Kelson and McNaughton in the ring at the same time.
Oh my God. Haven't seen those two.
And he takes down Kurgle. Maybe there's some forgiveness in this dojo.
Maybe. Oh, look at that axe kick there.
No, it's brilliant. EAP is just genuinely brilliant. And here's big PTK in the house. Beautiful.
There's Wolf Bart. Wolf Bart checking things out real quick. I'm being told that Purple Chest decided to go shit classic for this match.
Oh, Calcium's eliminated.
Yep, Calcium. The feud continuing briefly there. Calcium eliminating him, and sure enough, here comes Purple Chest. Just remembered this. The mustard madman himself, Purple Chest. That was someone I forgot to. Oh, well. Kurgle doing us all a favor on that one. EAB was your number two entrant. He is still in this match.
And still dominating, in fact.
Absolutely dominating. Oh, Calcium! Oh my God, PTK, another big man, could do well in this one if he can stay away from EAB's attention. Oh, I think this is it for Wolf Bark. No, no. Oh, that was a mistake, PTK. That was like taking Dark Elves to Blitz Pit. Yep, there you go.
Which incidentally he's done. He's the only one, isn't he? He's the only one with Dark Elves in the Blitz Pit team with him. Which will be a precursor to Survivor Series.
Well, Flicky Flack, you know, you're going to have to lobby the JFW. They don't seem to want to entertain their audience with Royal Rumbles. I don't know why. I do know why.
You might be able to if it's not live, actually. I'm just recording it off screen. Oh, here's Tarsus.
To be fair, I think you could have streamed. I think I could have streamed this live too. Wow, and K-Folk really, really putting up a fight. And here he is, co-founder of SHT, Tarsus. Will he have a better showing than he did in the tournament itself? He was one and done. Didn't get a win. Just lost in the first round. Now looking to maybe come back and redeem himself a bit.
He is just good. Oh, dear.
To me, the biggest problem with running Rumbles a lot is that I wouldn't want to run the other matches on the same quality settings. Mm-hmm. And having to, like, you can't save them, so you have to, like, go back and forth and change everything. It's a bit of a nightmare. Yeah. And Wolfbark, oh, is he going to drop out of the ring like an egg hitting the floor? No, he's not. Volcayo in next.
He's pretty sus, I tell you.
Yeah, Volcayo still looking to make a name for himself. Didn't have the best of tournaments. Had a good match, though. Oh, and PTK just laying out Tarsus.
I think this is about the most number of competitors we've had in the ring. Maybe EAB is getting a bit gassed, but not controlling it as he had done earlier.
Yeah, he's taking a little bit of a breather under the ropes there. As Wolfbark sent into the corner by PTK. No, not able to work on him, though. Ooh, and oh, wow. Volcayo just eliminated Kurgle there. Action getting hot. We are in our final third, folks. 23, Shawnee.
Oh, this chance is going to get in.
That is definitely not Shawnee's music. Oh, look at this. Wolfbark in trouble. Ooh. Shawnee taking him out right off the bat. No. Oh, now PTK helping. Ooh. And out goes Wolfbark. A competitor has been Oh, and Just Joe! Volcayo just ducked under Just Joe. Just Joe eliminated. Didn't get to hang around to try and exact vengeance on Muppet, who will be entering number 29. Lemon is Good will be entering 30.
I've got a pretty good idea who's entering 28 as well.
Oh, yeah? Who's that?
I think there's a certain shithead who made this whole thing.
So it was a random draw other than those final two. But yeah, we have not seen co-founder of shit, Skirmezzo, yet. And that's probably good news for everyone else in the ring currently.
It probably is.
Oh, Johnny sent flying. And number 24, one of the most fervent shitheads out there, Descotti.
There is no Crusher in this match, so his natural nemesis is not.
Volcayo having a great rumble.
He is.
Volcayo's about to die, though.
Yeah, he found
Volcayo had a great. Volcayo had a great rumble, and we'll remember him fondly. Wouldn't it be some? Oh no, KFO! Eliminating Descotti before he really got going. Volcayo could not lift EAB. No surprise there. And there he is, your extra arms bot champion, Aardvark.
And he specializes in beating you up, so this is the perfect kind of match for him, isn't it?
Absolutely.
EAB's really hurt. He has been in here since the start. It's amazing this is the first one you did as well. Holy shit.
I know. Oh no! Oh, K-Folk eliminates EAB. He was on such a run as Finney makes his entrance. Oh, what a shame. Oh no, there goes Tarsus. Volcayo eliminated Tarsus. And then Finney, Finney eliminating Volcayo. Look at that, fast and furious all of a sudden. And we're down to just a few more entrants. Oh, baby. There he is. The man, the myth, the legend, the king of kings, Skirmezzo, the co-founder of Skirmezzo's High Intensity Tournament, taking it right to Finney.
Come on, PTK, you can do it.
PTK, the only non-shithead in the ring right now, and I think the only non-shithead left in this rumble as Skur. Hey. Oh no, he eliminated. Oh no, Aardvark is out. So is Finney. No, Finney hangs on. Oh no! Oh no, Unseen Walker has shown up, clearly coming for Skirmezzo. He's got a bone to pick while he's going through PTK to get to him.
Oh boy.
Look at that, the Dwarf Slayer, the Scottish Mexican killer. Unbelievable stuff. He has signed on with Tony Plays Poorly to help defend the JFW from shit. As PTK working over Scaro, Finney working over Unseen. Here comes Muppet Pac-Man. We are getting real close to it, folks.
Oh boy.
Man, PTK and Unseen would love to toss out Skirmezzo in this one, but I don't think it's gonna happen. Oh, all the shitheads piling up. Everyone wants to win this match. And Skuro knows it. He knows he's put on a hell of a tournament. He knows he's gonna win this match. That is something.
Let's hope he doesn't.
Unseen. That sucks. Oh, and now both of the JFW remnants taken down Skuro. As Lemon makes his entrance
dog.
Here.
The cowardly dog cowers in the corner so they fight each other instead. Despicable.
And no love lost between Lemon and Skuro. Skuro eliminated from the tournament by Lemon is Good and went right after him. Oh no. Finney gone.
Yeah, look at Venom. final five, isn't it?
Oh no! And Muppet out, and now it's down to four. Lemon is good. Skirm, that's a, ooh, I do not like Skirm's odds here. Those are two guys that absolutely want to see him gone, and PTK wouldn't mind either, but apparently, oh, he's going after Unseen and Zed. Lemon is good. No, Skirm fighting back. Skirm would love to put Lemon over. Oh, Lemon eliminating. K-Fog, and now this is looking bad for our hero folks. Scaramezzo in serious trouble, but these two aren't going to let each other get the last laugh.
It's looking great for him. PTK, the non-shithead, just got eliminated. Now it's lapdog Lemon's left in.
Apparently. But I wouldn't say a lapdog. Again, Lemon eliminating Skuro from the tournament. There's no love lost there. Oh, could this be it for Lemon, though? It's hard for a Dwarf Slayer that short with that low center of gravity to try and hoist someone up and over. Skuro's stalking him, though.
Are we going to see the animation for the final three? It doesn't look like it.
I don't think so. Oh, Skuro's got him.
He's going to powerbomb him out.
Yeah, sure is. Good night, Lemon. A competitor. And we're down to our final two, JFW versus Shit, in as pure a form of competition as you can get. Scaramezzo versus Unseen Wonker. The last man over, or the next man over the ropes will be out, and we will have a winner in this pretty much meaningless match.
It's that meaningless, everybody, that Gorilla Mezzo spent the entire week replaying them until Skirl Mezzo finally won.
No, sir. No, sir. This is one and done. If you think I wanted to sit through that many 30-man rumbles to get a fucking result, you're fucking crazy. But here we go. Can Skirl win it for Shit? Will JFW steal a shitty win?
Come on, Unseen. Get that shithead out of there.
It's getting close to it. They're both very tired now. Both relatively fresh. They came in 27 and 28.
Yeah.
Oh, Skirl looking for that pop-up powerbomb.
Oh, God.
He's going to hit it, but he's not going to get him out. No, he doesn't get him over the rope there. Boom! There's an upskirt for you. And Skirl feeling it now. I think the end is nigh here. Skirl setting him up on the ropes. Oh, good night, Unseen. He's got him. Unseen trying to desperately to hang on. Trying to hang on. Skirl's got him over. One last chance. Unseen, can he hang on? Can he get him? Ah! Scaramezzo has won it, ladies and gentlemen. Unbelievable. The King of Kings. That's right. He knows it. He is leading Shit to JFW. He's taking them over at Survivor Series as he points at the sign. Skirl will be there Sunday, 8 p.m. UTC on Jimmy Fantastic's Twitch. Will you? Because they are gonna bring the thunder. And now it's time for your main event, Hell in a Cell, 2 out of 3 falls. Lean Guerra versus Fant Fox.
Hell in a Cell.
I know my voice is gone. Oh, I can assure you, this is your main event, Lean Guerra. What do these two have in store for each other?
Well, Auntie, I'm sure Gorilla Mezzo is never going to fucking shut up about it.
I think you might be right, Jim. The only man in JFW and Shit history to win a 30-man Royal Rumble on live television broadcast, Skirmezzo. legend, greatest of all time, question mark? That is a conversation to have at very least. And here we go. That cell will encase these two in just a few minutes. No one gets in or out of this one. It's going to be something.
Yeah, it's going to happen. And there's going to be a winner and a loser. And, you know, we the viewers will probably be the losers because we're watching shit and not JFW. But never mind.
Well, I think, Jim, I think if you just took a sip of some tea, took a nice deep breath, let go of this hatred you have that you're paid to have of this beautiful form of wrestling, you could enjoy yourself for this main event just like me and all 37 people watching and the millions at home, baby.
The 33,000 in the arena. We need a copy of Disrespect. Arena. It works though, doesn't it, with the wrestling arena? That's pretty good. But I tell you what, I am going to go and get a cup of tea. Sounds a great idea. This is a super exciting match, of course, but I'm going to. Yeah, I knew that was going to happen!
I don't know how to undo it though. There we go. Well, I don't know what happened there. I'm still learning all these OBS controls. All right, and here we go. Hell in a Cell, 2 out of 3 falls.
Right, yeah, I'm going to make a cup of tea while this amazing match goes on. Shit.
Fair enough.
To be fair, I mean, half of the match is amazing. Let's go, Lean Gary. Fuck him up.
I was going to say, a little lack of respect there for your two heads champion, Lean Gary. Or one half.
Yeah, well, I corrected it. Don't worry.
Go get your tea. Settle yourself in. It's going to be a good one, folks.
Yeah. Drop your pants. I mean, whoa, sorry.
Oh, and a quick pin here by FanFox, looking to steal one early. Only a 1 count. It's hard. It's hard to ever get in a Hell in a Cell match with anyone. It's extra hard when you got to go 2 out of 3 falls with them, and even triply so when you've already wrestled in one match, and those were both grueling singles matches. Look at these two, though, coming right after each other early on. FanFox hanging him up on the ropes there. And now FanFox in control, keeping a nice slow pace. No, the quick kick by Lean Gara, and then he drops him with the midsection kick. Lean Gara coming right back, dropping that elbow. These two have gone toe-to-toe before. Oh, nice clothesline to the back of the head there. Oh my goodness, it's Aurelensis. He's up there. It looks like he's trying to cast some sort of spell up on the top of the Hell in the Cell. Oh no, what is he thinking? Back in the ring, the action is going off. I don't know, I think he's trying to get in there to help his partner. Aurelensis looking to spoil another fucking match. No, but the Cell seems to be keeping him out. He's casting. He's desperately trying to get something going up on that ring. Oh, dear. And now the pinfall attempt here. No, just the 1 count. Oh, and Lemon. It's Lemon is good. Lemon is good is coming out. He's coming to the aid. He is. He's up on the top of the Cell. He's going right after. And there he is, he plants him, he's interrupted the spell. Lemon is good, has come to the assistance. of Fan Fox as he stomps all over Aureolensis. Action at the top of the ring there. And back in the ring here, Lean Garrett taking it to Fan Fox. Hard to keep track. I'm not even sure they know they're up there right now. Lean Garrett desperately coming back here with those clotheslines and stalking in on Fan Fox in the corner. Misses that stinger splash, the slow motion stinger splash. Oh no, the rock bottom! The rock bottom! He plants him with the rock bottom up top. Oh, Aureolensis taking it to Lean, or to Lemon is good. And it looks like, oh no, and Fan Fox still working over after hitting that rock bottom, still working over Lean Guerra. Lemon's got him. Oh, he's teetering. Dangerous situation here. Suplexes him right back onto the cage. Lemon is good, desperately trying to protect Fan Fox from the country wizard himself, interfering in yet another match. Oh no!
Oh, he sent him up! He sent him off the side of the cell, and he's climbing down and going after him, and he's battling him to the back. Look at that, Lemon keeping him as far away from the ring as he possibly can. The action continuing. Fan Fox going top rope.
Fan Fox lining him up, and he hits him. Ooh. Goes halfway across the ring to hit him with that drop, that missile drop kick. Lemon still taking it to the country wizard on the ramp now. And here's a pinfall attempt. This could be it. Or the first pin. No, just a one count. The fight continuing in the ring. Another flattening stomp by Lemon is good, keeping the country wizard as busy as he can. Lean Garrett coming back here, middle of the ring with those chops, quick kick, slams him down. Nice drop kick outside on the ramp there by Lemon is good. And there you go, folks. Of course, Lemon's gonna start celebrating. You knew it had to happen eventually.
Oh man, what have I missed here?
Oh, you missed pretty much everything, Jim. Aureolensis tried. Oh no! The Snackers! The Snackers Whoa. Have returned! And they're just laying out both Aureolensis and Lemon is good. What the fuck are the Snackers doing here? Disgusting!
Yes.
They had nothing to do with any of this.
JFW!
I don't know what I'm seeing here, just unleashing hell on Lemon is Good and Aureolensis. The Snackers have come for vengeance, and they are merciless right now.
Get fucked, shitheads.
Oh no, but the match continuing, still nothing, a nice spine buster there. Going for the pinfall, could this be our first pinfall? No! Snackers just taken down. Aureolensis and Lemon is good on the ramp there, savagely beating them. These two have already been going after each other, and now you enter the Snackers. And this is a nightmare, folks. Oh, and look at this, the crab walk by Fan Fox. You know what that means. It means it's time for the people's elbow. Will he hit it?
The fox's elbow.
And he hits the fox's elbow and he goes for the pin. This has got to be our first score. Oh, just a two and a half count. I thought he had it. Lean Garrett kicks out and the Snackers are murdering these two on the ramp. Unbelievable stuff. And I think that might be
the soul of the JFW. Brilliant.
Yeah, you know, Scaramezzo called his shot, said the heart was gone, the soul was dead. Oh, look at this, though. The Tombstone Pile Driver. Maybe he woke up the sleeping dragon in the Snackers who haven't been seen in weeks.
Oh, glorious.
Woke up the dogs, apparently. Oh, look, as they celebrate. As they celebrate their destruction of those other two at the top of the ring, I think that's it for them. Let's hopefully see if this match can come to a conclusion without any more interruptions, folks. Oh, Lean Garrett taking out Fanfox and going for the pin. Will he be our first one to score a pinfall? No, a two count. Oh, no, the snackers are coming. The snackers are coming, but there's a cage around them. They can't get in. It's a locked cage. There's no way in. I don't know what they're thinking here. Fanfox just continuing. He's got, oh, no, they're on the top of the ring now. What is happening? J5 hyping himself up for something. Oh, no. Oh, no. We got to see that again, folks. We got to see that again. That's how they got in the ring. Are you kidding me? The Snackers have found a way in the ring, and now they're ruining the whole main event. They're coming after everyone. They've just completely interrupted a match they had no business in, and now they're just tearing apart everyone. The unnatural Snackers have arrived, and they are making sure everyone knows it. Oh my gosh. They're just ruining the entire tournament. The entire tournament getting spoiled by these JFW pieces of crap.
Well, that's just what shit deserves, isn't it? Let's be honest.
Well, shit deserved a conclusion. Our audience deserved a better conclusion than this. This is just obscene. Absolutely obscene.
I mean, obscene, you mean glorious. I 100% agree. Yeah,
there's nothing glorious about this. There's nothing glorious about this. J5, I was their biggest fan. I was the biggest fan of these guys. I carried their careers with my tongue. And here they are. This is what we get in response. This is disgusting. Absolutely,
you certainly carried their nuts with your tongue, Gorilla.
Absolutely disgusting. A mistake I'll never make twice. It's just going right after the two heads champs. This is just absurd. Absolutely disgusting. I don't even know if we can have a match conclude. And I'm so sad right now, folks. I'm so sorry for what you've had to sit through with this. And what's happening to our feed now?
Well, Gorilla, it looks like the plug's finally been pulled on this second-rate piece of crap promotion. See you Friday, Gorilla, you shithead.
Motherfucker, and if you enjoyed that, I knew you had a part of this.
Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe and stay fantastic.